Heyo, it's Alachia. This is my Black Panther teaser review. Sorry, it is about 2 weeks late. I struggled with this, and I will talk about it. It has nearly nothing to do with the Black Panther in particular. It has more to do with my issues with Disney Marvel, and I really kind of just thought after the backlash I got from Thor, I really was wondering, is it right for me, you know, to talk about these teasers in the way that I like to talk about them, which is with a little, like, you know, a hinge of excitement with, you know, a touch of cynicism. And maybe I'm ruining people's joy about, you know, wanting to get hype. And so I just thought, well, maybe it's irresponsible to talk about my opinions because I'm just being a Debbie Downer and bringing up issues that I see here and there, while at the same time, maybe I am very excited about a movie. I have reservations always. And so I think Disney Marvel has given me cause to pause quite a bit. So I thought, well, if I don't do it though, then that looks bad. That if I just say now I've done all the teaser trailer reviews before and now this is the one I stop at, it just doesn't look good. So I thought about how am I going to do this? And I was like, maybe I'll just turn it into kind of a water cooler chat towards the end when I want to talk about some of the, I think, political agendas attached to the film, along with the way that I feel about Marvel Disney in general. All right, but let's talk about the Black Panther. So in Civil War, T'Challa was actually the character I found myself the most drawn towards because he had, in my opinion, the better arc of the entire stories. He started off as someone I really disliked. He was, you know, just too, you know, rational, too driven by emotion. He didn't have any of that checked. And by the end of the film, he really started to see things differently. And that may be, you know, maybe he'd been isolated so much, you know, under the protection of his father, T'Chaka, that now he's finally seeing that the world isn't so black and white. And I really love that. I really thought that it was great that he was the one to see that they were all being manipulated and he was the one to realize that. And then, of course, his skill sets are amazing. You know, it's just this combination of the physical prowess along with that suit, which is incredible. So, of course, I've been looking forward to the movie, especially because it's a property which I'm not that familiar with. So it's, for me, it's like Ant-Man or Iron Man, you know, Marvel properties that I have not been that familiar with. So I'm very interested. It's a story I haven't heard that much about. And so I can sort of appreciate going like, yeah, finally something like I don't know a ton of stuff about. I don't really know much about the characters or the character's history. And it's pretty fascinating stuff, too. So the stuff that they're going to be able to tackle. And I like that the way the trailer sort of begins with Ulysses Klaue talking about Wakanda. I always thought it was Wakanda, but he was like, Wakanda. and you're just like, all the assumptions you have about this place are wrong. It's actually a front to this amazing, like, technological, paradise. And so I like that the way they sort of open that up, that kind of reveal where it's just, oh, you think it's a bunch of shepherds and people that are just like, you know, living in some sort of tribal society, but it opens up and it's just this mecca of like amazing technology. And, you know, you realize like, you know, the vibranium meteor that had hit in Wakanda has really just created a society that is wholly, wholly unique because it is a society that developed technology outside of other influences, which is kind of amazing. Then we get into like the actual Wakanda scene. And I know what they were doing with the architectural thing with like putting the hatch roofs on these skyscrapers. It's just coming from an architectural background. It was just so cheesy. It's just like, it would be like in Texas if you like you put Spanish tile on top of a skyscraper here in Austin. It just, yeah, there's a cultural reference there, but technologically it makes no sense. But I kind of hated that I really wanted Wakanda to be kind of, I don't know, it felt like a cheesy kind of Disneyland thing that, you know, you would put a thatch roof on a skyscraper. But So I was a little disappointed because I was really expecting to see something different, especially because I had this assumption out of Civil War at the very end where you saw the statue of the Black Panther in the mist. And I just had this all these crazy ideas in my head because it was such a really good tease for what Wakanda was actually like. And so to see it, it felt a little too CG for me. And then with the thatch roof, it felt a little too cheesy. But then the trailer keeps going on and we get into this. I think I really liked it that they didn't do a lot of explanation. And so you really don't have a real grasp of like what the social structure is, you know, in this. And then it's a very unique situation too, because this is a superhero who's also part of a monarchy. And I think that's very fascinating because you have this technologically advanced society, but they still support a monarchy. And I think that that could, I have things, it's all like how much you like build in your head. And I have this idea about the vibranium meteor and how it affected certain people and how maybe some of the people could just be a little bit more affected by it. And so the bloodline is stronger in some, especially because you have the setups of the cults and the gods. You have the gorilla cult, you have the panther cult, and you know, that power dynamic, you can already tell within this teaser trailer that it's going to have a massive influence on this film, or it's going to be a massive factor in this film. And I'm very excited to see that. You know, I think Michael B. Jordan playing a Killmonger, I think he's going to be a devastating force. His story is kind of interesting in that, you know, it does make sense. You know, why does T'Challa get to be the leader of Wakanda, right? And then you have, that's going to be the dynamic that you get to explore. And I hope, and see, that's the thing, I hope it just doesn't come down to this basic, like, I'm better than you. I really hope they establish Killmonger with a really good backstory as to why he really feels, and that we can be even partially convinced that he should be, he might make that the better leader. Maybe that T'Challa is just not willing to do the hard thing, and that Killmonger is the one who can actually bring about, you know, real change, and especially from outside influences, because I think that the massive factor with Wakanda is whether or not they can protect themselves from being exploited from the resources that they have. Now, I find all that stuff fascinating. I think that could be a really good dynamic. And then there's like the factor that it's all based in the real world, because the way that Disney Marvel has set up the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And so you have Wakanda right next to a nation like Sudan. And you wonder, like, you know, they're going to completely ignore that stuff, right? You know, the fact that, you know, the nation right next door is going through massive, like, civil war and man-made famine. And it just, there's this Disney-fied version of everything that's going to just work out. And I hate that. I want it to be really serious. And there's this thing that Disney Marvel always teases a conflict that has massive consequences with Civil War, with, the trailer where Jane Foster looks like she's going to die in Thor 2. And there are, you know, or Happy was going to die in Iron Man 3. And that War Machine was going to die in Civil War. They always like have this heightened idea of like, oh yeah, this is real. This is serious. They're really dealing with serious things. And yet in the end, I know it's not. And that's just one of those things where I realize that's me, because I just dislike that they tease that, but then they don't give it to me. Now, if you just want to have a fun, good time sort of movie, I'm okay with that. You know, I'm okay. But they often continually tease that there's going to be massive, serious conflict. And I think that Coogler, who's directing the film, knows how to do drama. So I have if they let him have full reign, I'm sure he would actually produce exactly the type of movie that they're kind of teasing here. But I know Disney, and I just like what they're doing with the Marvel Cinematic Universe and with all their Marvel superheroes is basically turning them into Disney princesses, where, you know, you have this idealistic character who goes through a kind of arc with the, you know, a really dumb evil villain that they can defeat, and then you celebrate it by wearing all of their costumes and buying all of their merchandise, and it's just, I'm a little so over it. I'm just a little too cynical about the situation. But that being said, I know that the movies they produce are always super quality, and that even if I dislike, if I don't like love them, I don't ever hate them. And I think that after, you know, having really gone super excited about Doctor Strange and then it coming out being like, oh yeah, that's the, there's the formula. I'm not as excited, and I want to be excited about this movie, and I kind of am, but at the same time, I have lowered my expectations quite a bit, and I think it's such a shame. Such a shame that I have to lower my expectations, and I kind of just wish that Disney would give, like, people a chance to just really tell a compelling story with actual character arcs that, I don't know, have some real consequences. I mean, I don't understand how you have Civil War and no one dies. I think that the first time a character actually really, there was a significant death was in Guardians of the Galaxy, and but it really doesn't have a long-term consequence. And then you're going to have Infinity War, and I'm like, is there really going to be an actual war? Because, you know, in war, it's pretty ugly. And yet, you know, the way that they tease these things is just, and you're like, okay, Alachia, the shit is made for like 13-year-olds, so what the hell are you complaining about? I agree. I agree with you guys there. It's not made for me. It's not made for, you know, it's not made for my tastes in movies. And I can enjoy them for what they are. But I've just gotten to that point where I'm like, yeah, it's a Disney Marvel thing. And I'm just like, bring me Netflix, you know. And even Netflix, I feel like, has started to tame down a lot of its series, where I think Daredevil started off and it was like hard freaking R. And now I'm waiting for The Punisher. Because I want something that's a little bit, you know, a little bit more meatier. So, yeah, and that's the thing, is I didn't want, there's like this certain hype train, and I had read a bunch of stuff. This is where I'm going to go into like more of a water cooler chat portion of this video. So hang on. Where I'll just put the stickers on myself that just say racist and, you know, internalized misogyny and the white man's puppet and the things that people have called me. Because I saw a ton of comments, and this is what really made me really disheartened, was I'm seeing this effect with Black Panther that I kind of started to see with Wonder Woman, where there's this social agenda now attached to the film, which kind of concerns me. Let me explain why. So people were saying, oh, thank God, there's finally a film about a black character. I can actually spend my money to go see a movie, because I'm not willing to support, you know, a bunch of white people on the screen. I have to only see black people on the screen. It's, you know, finally we get to see what a civilized society looks like without the white man's influence. And there is this voice, and no, it's like not the majority of people, but there's this voice that's singularly focused on this identity politics about how this has to be the movie for the black people. And you know, I look at the Disney formula and I'm like, this is not just a black movie. This is another Disney, like, you know, Marvel princess movie. So I feel like as it goes on and as we get closer to the movie, I would really hate for there to be this polarization about race attached to this film. Because I think that, you know, I especially think that Marvel Disney films are just, they're fun. Like I said, they're not meant to be serious. Yes, it does mean a lot that they are tackling a black superhero, but, you know, my favorite black superheroes have already actually had movies, The Blade and Spawn. Those are two of my favorites. So it's not, I know there's an importance to it, but I don't want it to be this thing that really really like segregates people. And I saw that with Wonder Woman, and it kind of really bothered me that this became Wonder Woman was like a feminist movie. It was a movie about celebrating feminism. And I'm just like, no, it was just another kind of just, it's just a fun, silly movie about a superhero. And it wasn't, yes, there can be certain, you know, things attached. It's good to see representation in movies in Hollywood. But, man, I just hate for it to be this thing where if you don't like this movie, you're racist. I'd hate for it to be if you have any criticism towards the movie, you're racist. And I really hate the idea that, you know, there are already people talking about how they want a black-only showing. And I don't want this to be the thing that, like, adds... gives those people, those, you know, those minor people on the internet a voice to just really attach to just make things more, I don't know, just a lot worse. And it's gotten to this point online where it's really tough. It's really tough to have conversations about anything because the second you do, you are immediately pinpointed as, you know, this scum of the earth, racist. I've been called a house N-word. It's supposed to be a celebration of going to the theater to watch a movie about a superhero, but they become these, I don't know, these beacons for people to try to say, like, this is what the black voice sounds like, this is what the Asian American voice sounds like, this is what the female voice sounds like. And I think it's very dangerous to allow groups of people on the internet to speak for everyone else, you know, to speak for every other black person out there, to speak for every other Asian American out there. I saw that especially with the whitewashing stuff where these people were speaking on behalf of all Asian Americans. And I was just like, no, wait a minute. That's not how all Asian Americans feel about this. You know, and there are black people who are like, wait, no, not all black people feel like this. So I do find it a little disturbing, and I did see a ton of videos that were a little bit on the more racist side of things, which concerned me. And that's my biggest concern sort of going forward with the Black Panther, is that I really just want everyone to celebrate this character and sort of fall in love with him, fall in love with his journey, and come out, you know, just going like, hey, yeah, this is a really kick-ass character, as opposed to, you know, that's the black hero. That would be such a shame, don't you think? Anyways, that's something I've been wanting to get off my chest for quite a while. And I feel like I needed to take a few weeks to actually do this because the hype train was so huge when this first came out. And it was like, if you're not releasing a video of this, you know, reviewing the teaser going like, oh my God, this is so amazing, you know, it was not good news. So hopefully 2 weeks is a good enough time that I could just talk about it the way I wanted to talk about it and bring up the issues I wanted to bring up and, you know, let me know what you guys think. Again, I think it's really good to have a dialogue with people, and instead of like accusing them of being a scum of the earth racist, even if they are saying something racist, there is a way to approach talking to people that humanizes your voice, humanizes their voice, and I don't know, just makes things a little bit easier. I have an example, which I had a friend who, when they were talking about the Dormilaje, which are the bodyguards for Black Panther, they're the black women with the bald head, shaved heads, and then they've got the red leather kind of armor. And he made this comment that he was like, oh yeah, they're like these clones that are following him around everywhere, protecting him. And I was like, they're not clones. Those are all different black women. And, you know, I would just kind of like, but you know, like if you have that conversation online, how many people would attack you for saying like those, you know, how you're a racist, you think all black people look alike and they're all, you know, but the funny thing is that he thought that the chick from the daughter from 24, the TV series, was the same chick that was a daughter from Taken. So, you know, like there's this conversation you can have in real life where you can sort of laugh at someone's inability to distinguish facial features. And then there's like the mistakes, the missteps you can make online where you just say something honest and suddenly you're like fucking Hitler, right? Like, so it's just, it's interesting. It's really hostile now, I think, and it's making it very difficult to be online, to be on YouTube, to be honest, because it's just, it's rough. And I don't actually take offense to people calling me those things. What bothers me, what weighs down on me, especially because, you know, I can get down very easily, is seeing that how many people are angry. You know, seeing people that upset ends up making me upset. And it's not the personal attacks. It's just knowing that people have that are that angry. And I understand why a lot of people are angry. You know, I'm angry too. And I just think that sort of adds to my scope of the world and how I feel like it's just not a great place to be in at all, and that there's just a surmounting, you know, injustice that's just occurring, and people are getting angrier and angrier, and they're finding every way they can to lash out, and they're often lashing out at the wrong people. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this ramble. Sorry, it is kind of a ramble, but I am curious to know what your guys' thoughts are. Please don't call me. Actually, I don't care what you call me, but I don't know. Just think about what you say before you say it, because you may actually be misinterpreting how I feel, and you may be making assumptions about who I am. And if you just tell me what you're feeling and what you're thinking, rather than just calling me names, then maybe I can understand more like what your point of view is, rather than just thinking that you're a very hostile, angry person who needs help. All right. Thanks so much for watching, guys. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here or right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side.